guys, I'm Britta with Positive Pets of Dog Training. Today we're going to be talking about the use of interactive toys and how little puppies can really benefit from interactive toys and older dogs as well. We're going to start with what we would consider easy or simple puzzles, and then we'll work our way up to the more difficult ones. So these Kongs right here, they come in all different sizes, from puppies all the way to very large breed dogs, and they come in different colors. And the colors actually indicate how tough the actual Kong is. They're squishy, so when the dog sits there and chews on it and gnaws on it, it actually cleans their teeth. And for younger dogs, you can actually put like peanut butter or canned food or something that they like and freeze it and then give it to a little puppy, and it actually numbs their gums when they're going through the teething phase and makes them feel good. So the next one I want to talk about is what we call a kibble nibble. It's similar to a Kong in a way that it has holes on either end for treats to fall out of. How this works is that you unscrew it, you open up the center of it, and you can put kibble in there, you can put treats in there, you can put little pieces of chicken mixed with kibble. That way when the kibble falls out, it smells like chicken and they want to keep interacting with it. The cool thing about this too is you can actually adjust how big this hole is by cutting the little plastic pieces in there that make it a little bit more difficult for food to fall out. One of the things that we did with our younger dog is we would put his breakfast and dinner in here when he was a small puppy in order to slow him down from sucking up his food really fast. So not only was he getting early stimulation and learning how to problem solve and having fun, but also exercise. The next level up from a kibble nibble, and by the way, these come in sizes for large breed dogs and small breed dogs, but this one right here is a magic mushroom. It's similar in a way that you can unscrew the bottom, put kibble in there, put treats in there, whatever you'd like, and then the top right here unscrews and you can actually adjust the size of the hole where the treats fall out of in the center. So you can make it more difficult, less difficult for treats to fall out. They have to interact with it and get it to flip over for the treats to fall out, and they can eat it out of this bowl right here or flip it back over to get the treats to fall on the floor. Either way, they have to interact with it and smack it around with their paws or with their nose in order to get treats out of it. Okay, so the next one I want to talk about is what we call a bobble-lot. So this is what we would consider like a medium difficulty toy. And the reason being is that for one, there's two chambers, the top one where you put the initial treats or kibble in, and then there's one in the center. So the treats had to fall through two different parts while the puppy's interacting with it before the treats actually fall out of the exit hole. And there's only one part for the treats to fall out. So they have to hit it in the right direction to get that food to fall out. Not to mention that it's heavy at the bottom. So every time they hit it, it pops back up. Makes for a really fun game. All right, the next one is what we call a Kong wobbler. Similar to a bobble-lot in a way in that it has sand at the bottom. So again, every time they interact with it, it pops back up. Only one exit hole for treats makes it a more difficult toy. This is one of my German Shepherd's favorite toys to play with because it's big, he loves to carry toys around with his mouth, but it's also very, very durable. The final of the interactive toys, which is the most difficult one, is what we call a Buster Cube. So the reason this is so difficult is that this right here opens up, you put the treats in the bottom here, and you screw the centerpiece back on. They have to interact with it and push it in a certain direction so many times, the reason being is that there's a spiral staircase that the treats have to fall through in order for them to fall out of the hole at the very top. So they really have to interact with it and play with it for a long time to even get one piece of food to fall out. Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, my name is Britta, and you can come pick up any of these toys here at any Positive Pets location. We have one in Meridian and one in Boise as well.